everyone say, oh, hello, ladies and gentlemen. We're about to start the show, and I hope you enjoyed the pre-show concert as you guys are walking in. This very mature jazz ensemble has been pretty much picking all the songs we've been doing this year. That was Ella Fitzgerald. Very, like I said, you would think they'd be like, oh, I want to play Taylor Swift, or I want to play BTS, but there's nothing wrong with those groups. But it's not jazz, and they're like really cultured and really...
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for joining us again. We are so excited after spending two winter seasons not having our in-house concert. We're thrilled to be back here. Thank you for giving us all of your children. Thank you for working so hard for the past 3 and 4 years. And to our younger students that have been working hard, whether you just started 3 months ago or the past 4 years, thank you to all of you for sharing them with us. And then I would love to bring up Mr. Heathwood, who's here, Dr. Sato, and Mr. Lee, who's usually hiding in the back somewhere. If we can get him back here.
Thank you. Tubman was born into the harsh reality of slavery, and by age 5, worked as a housemaid and was rented out as a domestic servant. At age 12, she was struck by a metal wave when refusing to help capture a fugitive slave, cursing the rest of her life with narcolepsy and hypersomnia. Left without treatment, Tubman experienced vivid dreams, hallucinations, muscle weakness, and paralysis throughout the rest of her life.
In 1849, she escaped slavery by traveling 90 miles to Philadelphia. Search of freedom. However, she didn't stop there, but continued to help others achieve the freedom they deserved through the Underground Railroad. On her travels, she used the support of others she could trust and different modes of transportation to evade captures. The courage, strength, and passion she put into her work were always rooted in faith and her belief in God. In total, she rescued 70 enslaved.
sensitive. Tubman became the Moses of our people for her risk-taking actions and resilience, even faced with the consequence of death. During the Civil War, Tubman worked for the Union Army as a nurse, a cook.
The first woman to lead an armed military operation in the United States.
Despite the good Tubman had done for the people around her, she lived in poverty for the majority of her life after the war. Tubman took out many loans just to keep food on the table and a roof above her head. Many people, such as family and friends, asked the Secretary of State if she could receive financial compensation for her deeds. However, rather than being compensated for her own efforts, she only received aid for her late husband Nelson Davis' contribution to the war. Despite the financial burdens she had, Harriet Tubman continued to fight for the rights of her people and was an activist for the women's suffrage movement until her death. She died of pneumonia on March 10, 1913. On her deathbed, she told her friends and family, "I go to prepare a place for you."
So this was prepared by entirely by the students. Raise your hands if you wrote the draft.
I freed 1,000 slaves. I could have freed 1,000 more if only they knew they were slaves.
There is no better than adversity. Every defeat, every heartbreak, every loss contains its own seed, its own lesson on how to improve your performance. We need more light about each other. Light creates understanding. Understanding creates love. Love creates patience. And patience creates unity. Malcolm X.
Tell your untold stories. There is no greater avenue than bearing the untold story inside you. Maya Angelou.
Resilience is key. Be strategic and resilient in the pursuit of your dreams. This sounds like a cheesy quote, right? But no, I'm serious. Resilience is one hell of a quality, and it takes tough skin to have it. Tiffany D. Jackson.
If you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. Well, whatever you do, you have to keep moving forward. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
Now
it's
Thank you.
Thank you.
me sing with us. So I want to introduce this next group. This has been a new iteration in the Townsend Music Program. I feel like each year we're just adding more layers to the cake. And this is a student-led project, and the top musicians from the Wind Ensemble, the top band, wanted to continue exploring their musicality and going deeper into the realm of music. And so they formed a chamber music project, which is what you're about to see. And it's basically music without a conductor, where it's just each musician has their own part. It's very exposing, and it's very mature. It's a higher level ensemble. And Mr. Carlin Lee, who student taught with us last semester, is now working here with us and working with the group every Friday. So I want to give him a round of applause. In fact, the first piece we're going to do is an original composition by Mr. Carlin Lee. So another round of applause for composing for this group. Yes, commissions usually go for quite a lot of money, so we very appreciate the hookup. And then the second composition is a petite symphony by Gounod, but it was arranged by, again, Mr. Carlin Lee. So thank you and enjoy. Oh, yes. Enjoy the symphony with us. And I'm very proud of you, so you guys should be too. Thank you. this is one of our developing groups here in the music program. The cool thing about coming to Townsend, the music program has a place for everybody. We have people who have never played an instrument before until this class, which is the ensembles you see on stage right now. That is, let's see, basically like 2.5, 3 months of playing on their instruments, and this is what they sound like. So, can we get a round of applause? Before I got here, the concert band, the beginner band, didn't perform, at least at the winter concert. I'm not sure if they even performed at the spring concert. But I think it's important to see our developing groups and kind of see where it all begins, because the group, some of the other groups that you saw, like the Chamber Music Project and the Wind Ensemble, that's the end game. That's like where we're leading to, and a lot of the students that are in this ensemble right now are going to be in that ensemble next year, which, I mean, if they sound this good after 3 months, I can't imagine after 10. So, in addition to the beginner groups, we have our intermediate groups, and we have jazz, and we have modern band. There's just a lot of offerings. So I'm very proud to stand in front of these students and just see how far they've come. So I'm very proud of them. We got one more for you. It's called Bell Carol Rock, and we hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
So we are setting up for our very last musical number. I know it's a long show. We're running at almost culminating at 2 hours, but I do hope you enjoyed your time and kind of saw all that the Townsend Music Program has to offer from the beginning, from the beginners to the advanced, to the strings, to the band, to the chorus. There's a little bit of everything here, and we try to keep the variety going and nonstop music. So I would like to thank the students, and I would like to thank the parents for supporting us and hearing those squeaks and those practicing notes and doing everything you can to get this product amazing. So give yourselves a round of applause. I would also like to thank our amazing administration, Principal Condon, Ms. York, Ms. Fee, Ms. Brandeis, Mr. O, Bruce Steen, Brandeis, I think I said. Administration is great. They support us so much. Like all the stuff that we do, all the crazy ideas I have, I always get yes, and how can I make this happen? So thank you for the administration. Thank you for the custodial staff who are always giving us what we need. We need chairs, we need risers, we need this, we need that. To the tech crew, give a round for the tech crew. This is not happening behind the scenes, so thank you very much. My colleagues, Mr. Lee, Dr. Sato, could not do it without you guys, so thank you very much for, I'm the new guy on the block, even though I've been here, it's my 50 year, I can't believe how time flies. But we got an amazing team, and it's wonderful to be a part of it. Mr. Lee, am I forgetting anything? Would you like to say something? No? Cool. Well, hopefully I didn't forget anybody, but most importantly, thank you all for the audience, or for you guys sitting here right now, because you're giving us the love, you're giving us the energy to feed off of. So we're going to send you all one that you probably are familiar with. This is four movements from the Nutcracker, and this is the Townsend Harris, we've now become the Townsend Harris Symphony Orchestra, which is, yes, it's very exciting. Yes. Talked out, and I think it's time that we hear some Nutcracker and enjoy our evening. So thank you once more, and once again, the Townsend Harris Symphony Orchestra. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.